About to go all retro on you.
Shall we play a game?
Oh, hell nah. What's good, my old school PD peeps? Thanks for watching this tutorial to get retro textified using PowerDirector. Retro text makes it look like you're typing words on an old computer or an old word processor. It's a cool effect that can be used whenever you're using old school tech in one of your videos. Let's go old school. First thing that you want to do is you want to go to the title room. And you want to go ahead and grab the default text, left click with your mouse, and drag it down to the timeline track that you want your text to be on. If you want to, you can change the duration to whatever duration you want. Place your cursor at the end. Hold down your left mouse. When you see these two arrows pointed in opposite directions, drag this out to however long you want your text to be. Then let go of your left mouse. Then you want to double click on the text because you want to enter the title designer. And the first thing that we want to do is change the color of the text so that it looks like that old school retro look that you're looking for. So you can click on the color and choose whatever color you want. I know the RGB values of the colors that I want to use, so I'm just going to type them in. And once you have your colors typed in, go ahead and click on OK. Then we want to move the text all the way over to the left so that we have room to type everything onto the screen. So I'm going to left click on this once I see the crosshairs. Then I'm just going to use my left arrow key and move it as far over to the left as I want it. Then I'm going to double click in the text box to change the text. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the font first. So I got this font called Calculator from defont.com. Any type of old retro text that you can get from any font website will work. So I'm just going to left click in there and I'm going to type until I see Calculator pop up. Then I'll just hit enter and it'll change the text to that calculator text. Now, I want to start off my text with an underscore because whenever you do like that old school retro computer text, there was a underscore kind of flashing there. So I'm just going to go ahead and do an underscore. And I'm going to click on OK. Now, I'm going to go ahead and click on the home key on my keyboard to move my cursor all the way to the beginning. And now I'm going to move forward 5 frames by using the period key on my keyboard. Then I'm going to do Control T to split that clip there. And I'm going to move forward 5 more frames. And I'm going to do Control T, split that clip. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit the delete button. I'm going to delete everything after this. I'm going to double click on the second clip. I'm going to double click in the text box. And I'm going to go ahead and delete that underscore, and I'm going to click on OK. Now, what I want to do is create the flashing of the cursor by copying and pasting these two clips a few times on the timeline. So I'm going to use my left mouse, hold down my left mouse button here, and I'm going to lasso these two clips to select both of them. Then I'm going to do Control C to copy them. I'm going to go ahead and hit the end key on my keyboard. It should send the cursor to the end of the timeline. And then I'm going to do Control V. Then I'm going to do end, Control V, and do that as many times as you need to create as many flashes as you want. Now, if we go ahead and click on the home key, or let's go ahead and click on the timeline first, and then we'll click on the home key. If we play this back, we'll see a flashing cursor in the preview window. So now we need to go ahead and start putting in our text. So we're going to click on this last clip here and we're going to delete it because it's a blank clip. And then we're going to click on the clip right after it or before it. And then we're going to stretch this out to however long you want it to be. Now we're going to go ahead and click on the home key on our keyboard. It'll send it to the beginning of this clip. We're going to double click on it to open up the title designer. And we're going to go ahead and click in the text box. And we'll type the first letter of the word that we want to use. I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. We're going to use our period key on our keyboard to move forward two frames. We'll do Control T to split that clip. We'll double click on it and we'll add the next letter. And we're just going to keep doing this until we spell out the word that we want. Now that we got the whole thing typed out, we want to go ahead and make that cursor flash again. So we're going to move forward five frames by using the period key on our keyboard. We'll do Control T to split that. Move forward five more frames. Do Control T. We're going to delete this last clip by hitting the delete button on our keyboard. We're going to go to the second to last clip this time, and we're going to go ahead and double click on it. And we're going to remove this underscore. And we'll go ahead and click on OK. Then we'll select the last two clips. We're going to go ahead and do a left mouse hold down. Select those last two clips with the lasso. We'll go ahead and do Control C. We'll hit End. And then we'll go ahead and do Control V to paste it. And we'll do that as many times as we want. And then we'll go ahead and click on the empty part of the timeline. We'll hit the home button and we'll play this back by using the space bar to see what this looks like. Retro Text Flex. If you like what you see, I'll leave links to try PowerDirector for free and buy PowerDirector in the video description. Using those links helps to support the channel so I can make more content for you. I want to send a shout out to Team PDU for their support and for clicking the join button underneath this video. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.